Hey everyone, Miley Cyrus deleted her Twitter account, amen. And stay tuned, I'm gonna read some of your awesome comments and someone wants to kill me. I'm a social.
Love you, bitch. I rip it out whenever I can. What the fuck?
I had to have it. What the fuck? Miley Cyrus has deleted her Twitter channel, and that is such big news. Not like that Obama thing or that Mars thing, whatever. Miley had 2 million followers at her fingertips, and now they're gone. My first reaction was that was kind of dumb, because those are 2 million people who can run out and buy your CDs or your Walmart clothes if you tweet us to. Used properly by big stars, Twitter is a fantastic promotional tool and a great way to keep in touch with your fans, if used properly. Then I remembered Miley Cyrus really sucked at Twitter, so she had to delete it. It was a trail of religion and drama and whining and annoying cryptic song quotes that had to be destroyed. Thank God she's gone. We tried to make this girl Twitter happy. We sent her cyber hugs and cyber Jesus. Nothing worked. You know I love Miley Cyrus and I'm a huge fan of everything she does, but swear to Jonas, she was the worst Twitterer ever. They would have taken it away from her soon if she didn't do it herself. It was like a razor blade to the brain every time she updated. This is a good lesson for everyone. Twitter is not meant to be a page out of your personal journal. Sometimes your innermost thoughts are better kept inner. Miley was often complaining and you wanted to write back, "Shut up, you made $40 million last year. We just want to hear how awesome your life is. Where's the glamorous? The flouse, where's the free clothes?" Stars try to act normal and they think that if they show a real side of them, we'll like them more. We really don't want to see that. Look at Jessica Simpson. Her mouth is like a Twitter account. Please shut that shit down. It does no favors to your career. I'm sure Miley got many replies that were mean on a daily basis and it wore on her. Let the record show I was always respectful to at Miley Cyrus at Twitter. And her father was tweeting for her to come back because she is Destiny Hope, bringing hope to the world. Maybe it takes her more than 140 characters to bring hope, because I don't recall ever seeing much hope from this girl on Twitter. The initial reports were that she deleted her Twitter because her boyfriend Liam asked her to. I don't even know she had a boyfriend Liam, but okay. To clear this up, she posted a rap video on YouTube saying, "Goodbye Twitter." I will link the video here. I love it. I watched it and I said out loud, "Good for you, Miley Cyrus, and since you don't want us to judge your tweets anymore, I guess I will have to judge your rap." It was a little pitchy, dog, but she sounds very hoarse. I don't think you should have been doing that. If you're on tour and you sound that hoarse, maybe you shouldn't have been rapping, but you made some good points. If you tweet about pimples, the gossip sites cover it, and that must be annoying. And she says, "No more emo quotes or fake feuds with Demi. The truth is, I'm too busy." So you don't have time to Twitter, but you have time to write and choreograph and film and post a video about how you don't have time to Twitter. That makes no sense. Again, this goes back to you were not using Twitter properly if you somehow found it time-consuming. I love following celebs on Twitter because it's fun to make fun of them, and I love to Twitter because I am an internet personality, so this is what I do, so it's part of the fun, and I'm really good at tweeting, so every tweet is like, "Yeah, that was a good one, Buck." Follow me on Twitter, at Buck Hollywood, and we should always follow Friday, at Miley Cyrus, just to be funny. You know the account is going to pop up in a few months from now. You know it's going to happen. Congrats to Obama for winning the Nobel Peace Prize. Hey, that was such a hot Twitter topic. What do you think about it? The only thing I noticed is, when he was giving a speech, he looked irritated or embarrassed that he was accepting it, and then he tweeted, "Humbled," when he was done. Again, with the reporting on the tweeting. And then what happened on Mars? There's no aliens, so almond joy or something? Congrats to Streisand for having Barbara Streisand, for you young people, for having the number one album on the charts, beating Madonna and Mimi in a battle of the divas. Did you hear any of them? Finally, congrats to the word whatever for being the most annoying word. What word annoys you the most? Also, that made the list. I always say that. Two words. I always say whatever, and you know, so I must be really annoying. Whatever. Let's read some of your comments. Buck, have you ever worn a tutu? No, but if you send me one, I will. Thanks, What the Buck, for proving every male entertainment stereotype ever. You're welcome. I'm just here to entertain you. Hey, take off your glasses. I want to see what you look like without them. I can't see! Buck, I never get lost listening to you. I love how well you clearly enunciate, speaking so clearly at such a fast rate. I love your work. I hate you so much. I wish I knew where you live so I could kill you. Do you even listen to the lyrics? Probably not, huh? I bet you just like pretty sounds, don't you, idiot? I think we'll stop there. And if I'm dead soon, there's a suspect. It's like Twitter, a-hole. You leave a trail of evidence. If I turn up dead, they're coming after you. What the fuck?